Rasha, what does women's empowerment mean to you as a Syrian woman? And could you possibly give some examples of women's empowerment?
طبعا تمكين المرأة تحديدا بمجتمعنا له أكثر من معنى. الهدف الأول نحن نحول من مستهلك إلى منتج، سواء على مستوى الإنتاج المادي أو حتى الإنتاج المعنوي. يعني أنت تزودي أي امرأة ما عندها أي إلمام بكيف تهتم بابنها الصغير ببيتها، بمعلومات أساسية، بارتفاع حرارة الطفل، انخفضت حرارته، صار معه إشكال، كيف تتعامل معه. هاي كتير مفيدة. نحكي بالتمكين المهني اللي ممكن في مهن تعلموها النساء حولتها لمنتجات، مثل إنتاج الصوف. يعني اللي عم تشتغل صوف ممكن تشتغله وتبيع تصرف على عائلة، ونفس الشيء اللي عم تتعلم الحلاقة النسائية والتجميل أو التمريض. بالمجال التعليمي كمان نفس الشيء، نحن كنا عم نساعد الطالبات لحتى يدخلوا بعدها على الجامعة مثلا. فهذا تمكين. التمكين كمان من ناحية تانية إنه
ثواني بس سامحيني بس ما أنسى. So when I think of women empowerment, for me and for the women in Syria, I think about changing, you know, how ensuring that women and the women that we work with go from being consumers to producers, and not just, you know, in different ways, whether it comes to sort of materially or in terms of other ways that they are, they're sort of supporting their own communities. And so, for example, one example is even, you know, empowering a woman who, for example, maybe has a child at home and stuff, how to deal with certain symptoms and having, you know, for example, a elevated temperature or other things that, you know, medical things that, you know, that they could learn to help in their home life. At the same time, empowering them as well to be able to provide for their families and for their communities through vocational training, through their ability. So, for example, we had wool workshops, and you know, when you sew something together and everything, and you have the materials and you have the knowledge to do so, then you're able to sell that, you're able to provide for your family, you're able to provide for your community and for yourself, and be a positive impact on the overall local economy. The same applies academically as well, you know, being able to have the right knowledge, being able to have the degrees or and so on that can help you be a more productive member of society. تفضلي اختي سامحيني.
لا ما يعطيك العافية بالعكس. تمام. الموضوع الثاني بالتمكين هو انه اصلا تعطي النساء هاي المكانة، يعرفوا انه هن عندهم قدرات، كيف ممكن يطالعوا هاي القدرات، يواجهوا المجتمع اللي كانت بكتير من الأحيان خاصة ببيئة الأرياف أكثر من المدن. يعني إنه المرأة تصنيف تاني بعد الرجل، إنه هي شغلة بس بالبيت ومو قادرة أصلاً، مو قادرة تقدم شيء. هذا طبعاً كنت شوفه كتير مع النساء بنهاية الدورات أو خلال العمل. يعني وقت واحدة تشوف قطعة تلعب تشتغلها بعد ما تنجزها كتير تنبسط إنه أنا اشتغلت هيك، وبعدين صرت تفرجي هذا الشيء للعالم اللي بتعرفه، إنه كتير تكون مبسوطة على حالها، أنا اشتغلت، أنا انتجت، أنا صرت أعرف. مجرد إنه هي
Another thing that's an important aspect of what women's empowerment means to me and to the work of the center is that we know how amazing Syrian women are. And the fact is that they have amazing abilities and talents, and they are powerful. And so showing them that and training them and highlighting that they're able to be key productive members of society is really important. In addition, historically, and specifically in the countryside, in the rural areas of Syria, less so in the cities, women are seen as second-class citizens many times, that they belong only at home and they're unable to provide and they're unable to learn or be productive members of society. They just need to, you know, take care of the house and not do anything. And this is a mentality that is wrong and needs to change. And so it's been so wonderful to see how we've worked with women, even here in rural communities, in a way where we've empowered them and showed them and showed the entire society that they are an integral part of being able to sustain and support and be the spinal cord, really, of Syrian society on the ground. And I've seen so many of our graduates and so many of the people that have taken workshops with us, you know, these young ladies being so proud of their work. You know, if they sewed, for example, sweaters and learned how to do that, they're showing it off and saying, look, I did that and I'm able to provide and I can sell that. And so to increase their confidence and show them that, you know, they can be powerful, productive, talented, amazing people. That to me is women's empowerment.